students are there. I tried to give chance to all 50 students, 50 plus students. So be ready to answer to the questions, whatever I ask in between. Okay, you all know that in yesterday's class, we were discussing the chapter number systems. And particularly, we were focusing on the concept called surds, also called another way of defining an irrational number. That is, a surd is an irrational root of rational number. An irrational root of rational number is called a surd and is also the definition of an irrational number. You know the general form of surd. It is x into nth root of a, where x is coefficient, n is order, a is radical, and the symbol is, it is root. All the surds, nothing but irrational numbers, can be divided into two groups. One is like irrational numbers, second one is unlike irrational numbers. In case of like irrational numbers, orders of all irrational numbers will be same, and also their radicands. Example, it is root 2, then 3 root 2, then 5 into root 2, and so on. They are all like surds. In case of unlike surds, orders may be same, but radicands are different. Radicands may be same, orders are different. Both orders and radicands are different. So such surds are known as unlike surds. With respect to these two, we have come across another important point, that all the like surds can be added, subtracted, multiplied, and divided. That is, all the fundamental operations can be applied to these like surds. In case of unlike surds, they cannot be added, they cannot be subtracted. They can be multiplied if and only if their orders are same. They can be divided if and only if their orders are same. Dear students, in yesterday's class, we were focusing on addition of these irrational numbers, nothing but surds, subtraction as well. I think these two were over, is it not?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now let's go for continuing. I think how many four problems were over now?
Three problems were over.
Now let's start from fourth one. And these three problems are related to only addition and subtraction. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's move on to fourth one. Right. It is. Go on writing with me. 2 by 3 into root 7. 2 by 3 into root 7. Minus 1 by 2 into root 2. Plus 6 into root 11. Minus half. 1 by 3 into root 7. Please go on writing with me. Don't be lagging. Plus 3 by 2 into root 2 minus root 11. Let's go for simplify. Without wasting the time, you should go on writing with me. Yes, start writing. Write the given statement as it is. Here, 2 by 3 into root 7 minus 1 by 2 into root 2 plus 6 into root 11. Observe here. The second group is inside the bracket. To remove these terms which are in the inside the bracket, we have to multiply minus with all the terms. Here, minus 1 by 3 roots away. Then minus into plus minus 3 by 2 root 2. Next, minus into minus. It is plus, right? Plus root 11. Have you written? Okay. Now let's continue. For continuing, we have to group the like terms. Dheeraj SK, have you copied up to here? Oh, good. Let's go for identifying the like terms. Just observe. Here we have root 7 term, root 7 term. First, let us group them. Right with me. 2 by 3 into root 7 minus 1 by 3 into root 7. Afrin Sheikh, have you written? Next. Take root 2 term. Here root 2, here also root 2. Right. Minus 1 by 2 into root 2. Minus 3 by 2 into root 2. Next. Root 11 term. Here 1 and here 1. Right away. Plus 6 into root 11 plus root 11. Now let's go for simplifying.
Sir, why is 11, sir? We should take, it should be 6, no, sir. Only 11 is there. Last, sir, last one. Last plane. No, sir, that. This side 6 is there, this side not there, not there.
This side 6 is there. Look here. In root 11, in this term, coefficient is 6. In this term, root 11, coefficient is 1. So that we have written 6 into root 11 plus just root 11 only. Now, let us go for simplifying the terms. We have already made the group. Okay.
Sir,
by either by taking
Sir, first we should take small number, no, sir. Why you taken 7 and 2, sir? First 2 we should take, no, sir.
No rule that. You may say 3 plus 2 is 5, right? 2 plus 3 will also be 5.
Yes, here,
order is not responsible. Sum is responsible. We should get the correct sum. Yes. Here, in the first two terms, you may take root 7 as common factor and simplify. Or else, you may also go for simplifying it directly. Here,
1 by 3 root 7
as common factor. You will get 2 by 3, then minus 1 by 3. Hope you have copied. Ranjan or Pisale. Copied?
Yes, sir.
Here, root 2 is common factor. I take plus root 2, remaining minus 1 by 2, minus 3 by 2. Next, in this, root 11 is common factor, right? Plus root 11, remaining 6 plus 1. Actually, this step is not necessary. Directly, you can go for simplifying. Only to make you to understand, I have written so.
Sir, why you took plus beside square 2, sir?
When you go for taking the plus, it will not affect the given term. See, I have written plus. And remaining terms, whatever is there, I have written as it is inside the brackets. Here, minus 1 by 2 is there, I have written. Minus 3 by 2 is also there. Next, this is equal. Root 7. Take LCM and simplify. Denominator terms are same. 3. Numerator 2 minus 1. It is 1. Next, plus root 2. Your denominator terms say LCM will be just two only. Next, here minus one minus three is minus four. Next, here six plus one, seven. Seven into root log. This is equal to.
We can cancel minus 4 by 2.
We can. First, I write first term. Here, it can be written as root 7 by 3. Now you may cancel. 2 ones are, 2 twos are. Minus 2 is there. Minus 2 into root 2. Minus 2 into root 2. Next, third one. Plus 7 into root 11. Hope that you have understood.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Tejasvi CP, did you understand? For your response, you can use like this. Yes, sir. No, sir. Got it? Yes. Manasa L, did you understand? Yes, sir, I understood. No, sir, I have not understood. Please explain it. You can use this symbol, sign, this sign. Now, let's focus on next one. Total four are over, and these four are related to addition and subtraction, which is next to fundamental operation. Multiplication. Look here. Here root 7 is there. Then root 5 is there. Is it possible to multiply?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Order up.
Kaula Sheikh. Is it possible to multiply these two?
Yes, sir.
Why? Shamita T. Ekbote.
Yes, sir.
Why it is possible to multiply?
The orders are same. Orders are same.
Very good. Then loudly.
Orders are same.
Very good. Order of each irrational number is same. Here is 2. Here is 2. Hence you can multiply like this. It is square root of 7 into 5. This is equal to square root of 35. In the same way. 3 into, root 5 is there, into cube root of 7. Is it possible to multiply?
No, sir.
No, sir.
It's not possible.
No, sir.
Order is different. Here is
order is different.
3.
3.
So, if you want to multiply irrational numbers, particularly monomial irrational numbers, nothing but thirds, orders must be same. So now I'll go for taking such example. Right. Multiply 6 into root 5 by 2 into root 5. 6 into root 5 and 2 into root 5. You can go for multiplying yourself directly. We have 6 into root 5 into 2 into root 5 to represent multiplication. I'm not going to use cross symbol. Instead, I'm writing the term inside the brackets. Now, this is equal to your students. One thing you must follow when you are multiplying these like thirds. First, go for multiplying. Coefficients. Here 6 is there, here 2 is there. 6 2's are
12.
Here, root 5 into root 5, it is square root of 25. And square root of 25 is
5.
You may also write root 5 into root 5 as root 5 whole square, because it is repeated by 2 times. Square and root get cancelled. Again, it is 5. For him, did you understand? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
No.
Sir, can you explain once again?
When you are multiplying the sums, first you have to observe order. If order is same, then you can go for multiplying. If order is same, now first you multiply the coefficient. 6 and 2. 6 2s are 12. Next, root 5 and root 5 is there. Root 5, as it is repeated by 2 times, you can write root 5 whole square. Then square and root get cancelled. We get only 5. Multiply it by 12. 12 5s are 16.
Sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
Please go for copy. Manya, did you understand? Good girl. Copy it. Ignayas, did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Very good girl. Rutushri? Yes, sir. So just this side is enough. Okay. Now let me go for taking another one. Sixth one. 7 into root 5 into 11 into root 6. This can be written as 7 into root 5 into, that is, I'm using the common brackets. 11 into root 6. Multiply coefficient. 11 sevens are 77. Then square root of. Here root 5, root 6 is there. This can be written as square root of 5 into 6. 5, 6 are 30. That's all. Right. Further simplification is not possible. Write this as it is. Next. 7th one. Multiply 5 into cube root of 7 and 3 into cube root of 5. Let's go for multiply. 7 into 3 into 5.
Sir, is it possible to multiply? Sir, yes, if sir. Root has different value,
is it possible?
Yes, sir.
Could you tell the reason?
The order is same.
Very good. Order is same. Here is 3, here is also 3. Go for multiplying. It is 5 into cube root of 7 into 3 into cube root of 5. This is equal to, multiply the coefficients. 5 threes are 15, then cube root of, multiply the radicands, 7 and 5 is there.
7, 5, 35.
Hema Yogesh, your name is Prithvi, no? Prithvi Raj. Okay, now let me go for taking next one.
Sir, I have a doubt. Sir, yes. If the
If the coefficient is same and the radicand is different, how should we do?
Radicand, sir. I'll take one such example. Don't go for copy. Just observe. Here, 5 into square root of 3. And 5 into square root of 11. You are telling that, sir, coefficients are same. Radicands are different. Same. Multiply coefficient. 5, 5 is 25. Then order is same. You can write root as it is. 3 is there. Here, 11. 11, please. That's it.
Okay. Sir, yes, sir, if orders are different.
For that separate method is there. I'll teach you that also. At this time, if I go for teaching you that, you may get confused. So that now I'm not taking. In when we are solving traditional problems, in that time I'll take. Next. Right. 8-1. Now, this time we are dividing. Divide 8 into root 15 by 2 into root 3. Please stop writing. Stop writing and observe the board. Chinmay Kashyap should observe the board. Rakshita B. Look here. Here we have two terms. 8 into root 15 should be divided by 2 into root 3. In general, we can write like this. 8 into root 15 in the numerator divided by 2 into root 3 in the denominator. 2 into root 3. Prashast, just look here. Just look here. Don't go for writing. I'll give you time for writing. Observe. Yeah? You can notice that. Order of root 15 is 2. Root 3 is also 2. Order is same. Dear students, I have already told you that. When the order is same, you can go for either multiplying or dividing. Observe the coefficients. Here 8 and 2 are there. Cancel them. 2 ones are, 2 fours are. Then, here, order is same. 2, here 2. That is why I am writing like this. In one root only, I am going to write both the numbers. 15 by 3. Did you understand?
Sir, 15 by 3 will cancel now, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now I am going to cancel only. As the order is same, I am writing 15 and 3 in one root only. Now, this is equal to 4 into square root of. We can cancel. 3 ones are 3, 5.
5.
4 into root 5.
Sir,
got it?
If that number did not cancel.
Sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, square root of 3 and square root of 15 get cancelled. Only root, sir.
Root won't get cancelled. Sir,
okay.
Root won't get cancelled. Only the radicands. You can simplify the radicands.
Sir, if the radicand is not divisible by that number, what we should do, sir?
You have to keep that as it is. If possibilities are there for cancellation, cancel it. If not, write that as it is.
Sir, we can write direct.
Now, next one. Prithvi, you can write it direct here. Let me go for taking another one. Right. It is 9th one. This is 44 into cube root of 32. Why? 11 into cube root of 4. 11 into cube root of 4. Anybody would like to tell the answer?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I'll say
4 by 8.
I'll give you chance.
4.
Yes. Sir, 4 by 8. Sir. Yes, sir.
Tell that.
Sir, we should divide 44 and 11, sir. 4.
Oh.
It will come 4.
It will go for cancellation.
Cancellation.
Writing it directly. Prithvi, I'm sorry. 11 ones are 11. 4. Next for that.
8. We should cancel 32 and 4 by 8. 4 tables, sir.
4 tables is correct only. But before that, what should be done?
Root 32 by 4.
Root. Square root or cube root?
Cube root.
Cube root. 32 by 4. Now we can go for cancellation. 8. Is it that is equal to 4 into cube root of 8? Dear students, can it be simplified further?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Two cube.
Yes, sir.
Your turn.
Sir, 8 is equal to 4.
Sir, 8 is equal to 2 cube.
8 is equal to 2 cubes.
Yeah. 4 into cube root of 8 is there. 8 can be written as
2 cubes.
Cube 1, cube root get cancelled. 4 into 2 is 8.
Cube root and cube get cancelled.
Don't speak in between, Prithvi. Observe. Rashas, did you understand? Okay, good one. Yes. 2 cubes. We get 2 cubes by like this. Here, 8 is there. Here, 2, 4, 2, 2, 2. See that? 2, 2, and 2. 3 times. So it is 2 by 2 to the power 3. Now, here, cube root and cube get cancelled. You will get 4 into 2. Now, it is 4 into 8.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Arushi.
Yes, sir.
When you wanted to speak, on that time only, you have to unmute your audio.
Okay, sir.
Otherwise, always mute your audio.
Okay, sir.
Register, continue, sir. Sorry.
Sir, the 4 by 2 will cancel, no, sir.
Here is no 4 by 2. It is 4 into 2. 4 into 2. It is not in the denominator. So, 4 twos are 8. Rakshita B. Copied. Okay, good girl. Now I'm moving to second one. In first question only, we are solved. 9 sub questions. Now we are moving to second one. Here, they are given few problems to check your previous knowledge also. Right. Question is like this. Find the product of Shreyas, copy. Find the product of 8 plus 3 into root 2 and 8 minus 3 into root 2. Please go on writing with me. The given numbers are 8 plus 3 into root 2 and 8 minus 3, 8 to root 2. As we have to find out the product of these two, I'm going to multiply. This is equal to Shivan P. Nalpet. Could you tell how do you go for multiplying these two?
Sir, 8 into 8, sir. We should multiply, sir.
8 into 8, okay.
Yeah. And 8 into minus 3 root 2.
Into root. Okay, you are moving to actual method. Ritika, could you try? Ritika, I.
Sir, I have a trick, sir.
Sanvi, just listen to me, Sanvi.
Yes.
Yesterday, when we are representing square root of decimal numbers on the number line, we went for calculation, right?
Yes.
In that calculation, a term was transferred to left side.
Yes.
Then we did not go for finding actual squares. Instead, we use the identity. Could you recall that identity?
A square minus.
Abhinandan, be quiet. I'm giving chance to Sanvi.
Sir, A square minus B square.
Very good. What is that A square minus B square?
Plus 3 minus 3.
No. Here, how do you explain this?
Sir, can I?
A plus B into A minus.
Sir.
Okay. Manasayan, you try. How do you write A square minus B square?
Sir, shall I say?
Sir.
Sir, can I?
You write A square minus
B square. Sir, shall I say?
A plus B into A minus B.
Very good. It is A plus B into A minus B. Similarly, if A plus B into A minus B is there, it can be written as A square minus B square. And you can notice that. Here, terms are same. A into A. Then here, 3 root 2, 3 root 2. It is A plus B and this is A minus B.
A minus
B. Can we write this as 8 whole square minus 3 into root 2 whole square? Can we write so?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Write the same. 8 whole square. 8 whole square. Then minus 3 into root 2 whole square. Yes. Giridhar. Trupti, look here. Look at the board. You are looking back. Giridhar, what is 8 square? Trupti, you tell. What is 8 square?
64.
Very good. 64. Then, Lakshmi Shri, don't try. Observe this term. 3 into root 2 whole square. Can you simplify?
Root cancel.
We can cancel roots.
We can cancel and root two.
The roots will be canceled.
Lakshmi, she is responding. You are telling that, sir, we should cancel 2 and root. Okay, let us accept. Any other? Wait. Chandana, you? Will you try? What may be the answer? You may tell the answer directly. This one. The value of 3 into root 2 whole square. Chandana. Mohita Biji. Not trying.
Square cancels.
Okay. Shreya. Will you try? What is the value of 3 into root 2 whole square? Sai Gaurav, don't try.
6, sir.
6. You are telling 6. No, it is wrong. Ketan Bemani. Ketan? Okay. Shreya D. Prerana K. Kanasaplak.
Sir, 18, sir.
It is. Excellent. Very good. This girl is correct. Prerana, could you tell how did you get that 18?
Sir, 3 3s are 9 and square and square get cancelled, sir.
Very good. Very
square
good.
Root.
Here, 3 into root 2, whole square is there. This square is applicable to both. Okay. 3 into root 2, whole square. You can apply square to 3. It is 3 square. You can also apply square to root 2. Root 2 whole square. Now square and root get cancelled. Then you have 3 square. 3 square is 9. 2 will remain. 9 2s are 18. Hope that you have understood. Arvind B. Dodgowda.
Yes, sir.
Where are you?
Yeah.
Okay. Arvind, okay. Here I'll write. Here 3 square is 9 and root 2 whole square is 2. If the terms are like this, please apply square to all the terms. Next.
Sir, afterwards we should minus 64 minus 18, sir.
Not so minus. It is just 64 only. Minus as it is. Now 9 to the 18.
Sir, answer 46.
Answer 5 will remain. 5 minus 1 is 4. 46.
4. 46.
Arvind Dodgowda. Arvind.
Sir. Sir.
Not able to see your face. Only back door is up here. Have you written the same?
Sir.
Now, I'll take one. Third one, right. Third one. Simplify. It is 8 plus 5 into root 3 whole square. 8 plus 5 into root 3 whole square. Written up.
Yes, sir.
Sarthak Hardy. Just observe the given term. It is 8 plus 5 into root 3 whole square. It is in the form of an identity. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Now, could you tell what is that identity? Sarthak? Shreya D. What is in, it is in the form of which identity?
Plus B square. A plus B whole square.
A plus B whole square, sir.
It is A plus B whole square. Aditya, you only, just expand that A plus B whole square.
A square plus 2AB plus B square.
Very good. A square plus 2AB plus B square. When you are sitting to the next class, you have to use full T-shirt, okay?
Yes.
Okay. It is in the form of an identity A plus B whole square. According to that, let's go for expanding. Right. Write down. It is 8 plus 5 into root 3 whole square. This is equal to, as you said, is of the form A plus B whole square. According to that, A square plus B square plus 2AB, or as A square plus 2AB, B square. And both are same only. In place of A, we can write A. In place of B, we can write 5 into root 3. One substitute. A is 8, B is 5 into root 3. Next, A is 8, B is 5 into root 3. Substitute. This is equal. Yes. Larissa, what is A square?
64.
Next, Druti P. Druti, can you tell the value, this value directly? 5 into root 3 whole square?
75.
Druti. Sir. Amulya CK, could you try? Amulya CK, what is the value of 5 into root 3 whole square? I told you, apply square to both the terms. Here, 5 square is 25. Root 3 whole square. Square and root get cancelled. 3, it is. You can tell its value directly as 75. Ravi Shankar. Now multiply only the coefficient. 2, 8, and 5. How much it is? 7 BA, you can also try.
Yes, sir.
I want quick answer. Sanjana SN. Just to multiply only coefficients.
80.
How simple it is. See that 2 8s are 16. 16 5s are 80.
80.
Or 5 2s are 10. 10 8s are 80. 80 into root 3. 80 into root 3. Now this is equal to here 25 3s are 75. I'm adding it directly. 75 and 64. How much? 139. Here
9 7 plus 6 13 130 plus 80 into root 3
Yes,
sir. 25 whole square, whole 3 is there, sir. 3 is a 9.
No, here, what, Gaurav?
Yes, sir.
Here, square is there, no? It is applicable to both. When you apply square to 5, 5 is a 25. When you apply to square to root 3, in root 3 here, square na apply maadi. Square matte root cancel agutte.
Yes, sir.
Avaga 3 aste barutte. Ill enadru bari 3 idre. 3 whole square idre avaga 9 barutte. 3 square is 9.
Yes, sir.
Understood. Very good. Now, I'll go for taking another one. Last problem. Then, right.
Sir, this much only final answer, sir.
Yes.
We can't add 139 plus 80 into 3 square.
We cannot. Look here. This is an irrational number. E is a rational number. Rational number cannot be added to irrational. Next one, right. Again. It is fourth one, no? Right. Simplify. 5 plus root 7. 5 plus root 7 into 2 plus root 5. We are going to simplify it. Right. 5 plus root 7 as it is. Into 2 plus root 5. Here we are not in any particular form. Under such condition, observe, you have to multiply 5 with both the terms, then root 7 with both the terms. I'll write it. Go on writing with me. 5 into 5 should be multiplied to both 2i root 5. Next. Plus root 7 into root 7 into 2 plus root 5.
2 plus root 5.
Now, this is equal. Did you understand the way I have written? Ananya,
yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Chinmay Kashyap GH, did you understand? Yes or no? Yes. Salik?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay. Smok? Understood or not? Okay.
Sir? Sir? Sir, explain once again, sir.
Here, the terms are different. So they are not in any particular form. Under such condition, here, each term should be multiplied to this 2 plus root 5. See, 5 into 2 plus root 5, then root 7 into 2 plus root 5. Now let's go for multiplying here. Multiply 5 with both the terms. 5 2s are 10. Plus 5 into root 5. Next, multiply root 7 with 2. Root 7 into 2. It is 2 into root 7.
Yes, sir.
Then, plus, now you observe here, root 7 into root 5. Root 7 into root 5. Both are like. Like means?
Root,
what are you saying?
Root
35.
Root 35.
7,
5
are
35.
Right, root 35. Can it be simplified further?
No, sir.
No, it's not possible. You may keep that as it is. Trupti, did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes. No. Rutushri? Yes. Chandana? Prerana? Chetan, yes, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Abhinandan?
Yes, sir.
Prajwal SM? Good. Good, 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 good. Yes, yes, yes. Siddesh BA, did you understand this? Say yes or no. Yes. Okay. Dear student, these are the some important problems. Now we are moving to the next concept. Sai Gaurav, you have to just observe the board. Now you no need to go for writing anything. Just look at the board. Amulya CK, I think your writing is not yet over. Good. Just observe. Here I write a number 2 into root 5. Could you tell what type of number it is? Rational or irrational?
Irrational.
Irrational.
An irrational number.
Irrational.
An irrational number. Prerana, K. Kanasapla. Can
yes,
sir. A rational number by multiplying any number. Our intention is to convert this irrational number into rational number. To convert this into irrational into rational, we have to multiply this number by a suitable number. Ananya SN, could you try? Nobody is trying. Nobody is trying. Arushi?
Sir, we have to find the square root of.
Sir, we have to find the square roots first.
No. You are not understanding my question. Here, my question is, This is an irrational number.
Yes, sir.
Now, yes. This number should be converted into rational number. To convert this into rational number.
Sir, into
2. So we can multiply 5 into.
Multiply by 2, sir.
Multiply, sir. We can multiply.
See that. Here, 2 into root 5 is there. It should be multiplied by a suitable number.
Sir, 2, sir.
Sir, 2 we can do.
Sir, 2.
You go for using 2. If you multiply by 2, it will be 2 2s are 4. 2 into root 5. Into 2. 2
2s
are 4. 4 into root 5. Again, it is irrational.
Sir, 5.
Sir, 4.
Sir, 5.
2 into root 5. As
sir, 2 5 into root 5. 5 whole square will come, sir.
2 5s are 10. 10 into root 5. Again, it is irrational.
2 into root 5 whole square.
Sir, any irrational number we can try, sir, instead of for rational number.
Isn't it? Somebody said that. Sir, 2 into root 5 whole square. Absolutely, is right. Look here. 2 into root 5 is there. If I go for multiply, again root 5. Observe. Now this can be written as 2 into root 5 into root 5. Root 5 whole square. Square and root get cancelled. Now here 5 is there. 5 2s are 10. 10 is a rational number. That means, Demani. Ketan, observe. This is an irrational number. To convert this irrational number into rational number, we have multiplied another irrational number. So this process of converting an irrational number into a rational number by multiplying another irrational number, this process is known as rationalization. See, rationalization. Converting irrational into rational. Converting irrational into rational is nothing but rationalization. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If it is so, now you know. Mohita Vijay should look at the board. 5 by 7 into root 11 is there. What do you multiply?
Root 11.
Root
11. See that. It is an irrational. We want rational. To convert this into rational, what should be multiplied?
Root 11.
Root 11. Root 11.
Then it becomes irrational. If I take 10 into root 26,
Root 26
should be multiplied. Right? Then, if I take root x.
Root x
must be multiplied.
Root x should be multiplied. Neera, just think and tell. Another one. Suppose 2 plus root 3 is there. What should be multiplied with this to get rational number?
Root 5.
Root 3 whole square, sir.
Root 3 whole square.
2 plus root 3 whole square.
See? Okay.
Root 3 minus 2.
Okay. Let me tell you what are 2 plus root 3. Some of you told that. Sir, let us multiply root 3. When you multiply root 3, root 3 into 2, 2 into root 3. Root 3 into root 3, root 9 is nothing but 3. It is irrational, not rational. And you said that. Sir, again we have to multiply 2 plus root 3 only. If you multiply 2 plus root 3, it will be 2 plus root 3 whole square. And this is of the form a plus b whole square. A square plus B square plus 2AB. 2 into 2 into root 3. Here 2 square is 4. Root 3 whole square is 3. Here 2 is a 4. 4 into root 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. Again it is irrational. Then what should be multiplied?
2 minus root 3.
Who is telling that?
Sir, Manik. 2 minus 2.
Are you Lakshmi Shri?
No, sir, Mani.
Who is telling?
Sir, Manya.
Ah, Manya. Okay, okay. Manya, you are right. Definitely, she is right. Let me tell you why. She said that, sir, to convert this irrational number into rational number, we have to multiply 2 minus root 3. But I'll give the reason why it is suitable. It is of the form a plus b into a minus b. It can be written as a square minus b square. A square is 2 whole square. B square is root 3 whole square. Now square root get cancelled. 2 square is 4 minus root 3 whole square is just 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. 1 is a rational number. Understood? Very simple. If two numbers are there in the irrational, if two terms are there, just change the sign.
Sir, we are
right minus.
We want to take a plus b, a minus root 3.
A plus b. Abhinandan, Abhinandan. First, you have to listen to the explanation, or else it will be a disturbance for others. When the explanation is over, then I'll give the chance. In that time, you can ask me. Here, 2 plus root 3 is there. To convert this into rational, we have to write 2 minus root 3. Suppose 7 minus root 3 is there. Then to convert this into
7 plus root 3.
7 plus root 3.
Root. Got it? Abhinandan, you tell now. What
the? Sir, we want to take a plus b, a minus b.
Not only we have taken a plus b into a minus b. Look here. These are the numbers which we have multiplied with the given irrational numbers to convert them into rational number. Such numbers which are to be multiplied, they are called RF. Do you know what is RF?
Rationalizing factor.
I told you so many times to go through the textbook. Siddesh, don't touch the mobile. Just observe. Okay. Yeah, these numbers are called rationalizing factors. The numbers which are used for converting irrational into rational, they are called rationalizing factors. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Root 11 is the rationalizing factor of this. Root 26 is the rationalizing factor of this. Similarly, root x is the rationalizing factor of root x. Even these are also. But particularly, here in these examples, last two examples, we have two terms. If two terms are there, we go for using another word called conjugate in place of rationalizing factor. You may use rationalizing factor or conjugate. Understood? Now we say that the conjugate of 2 plus root 3 is 2 minus root. The conjugate of 7 minus root 3 is 7 plus root. Got it? Yes.
Yes, sir. Now,
you write the side heading. Rationalization. The method of converting. Write down. Prajwal SM, go on writing. The method of converting an irrational number into a rational number. The method of converting an irrational number. An irrational number into a rational number. Rational number by multiply an irrational number by multiplying a suitable irrational number is called rationalization. Written, no? So here, reading here, written, no? There, just one symbolic form. Q. Just by observing that only, you can understand. We are converting irrational number into rational number. That's all. Next one. Rationalizing factor. In bracket you may write conjugate. Underline. Put colon. Right. An irrational number which is to be multiplied with another irrational number an irrational number which is to be multiplied with another irrational number, nothing but given irrational number, to convert it into a rational is called rationalizing factor. Manasa, are you writing? Sanvi, copied? Okay. Good. Dutch, have you copied? Okay, good boy. I'm going to give you two columns. In one column, you'll write an irrational number. In another column, you'll write rationalizing factor or conjugate. Right. Irrational and rationalizing factor. This is side heading. Irrational and rationalizing factor. You have to make two columns. Draw this quickly. Right. Yeah. Irrational number. This is rationalizing factor or conjugate. First one. 3 into √10. Vibha, what is the rationalizing factor of 3 into √10?
Root 2, sir.
Root 10.
Root 10 only.
10.
Next. Second. 3/7 into √11. Sanvi, you tell.
Sir, root 11.
Root 11. It is root x. Shreya D. Shreya, tell, what is the rationalizing factor of root x?
Sir, root x.
Very good. Root x. Fourth one. Please think and tell. Ekmote. What is rationalizing factor of square root of x plus 1?
X minus 1.
Anvikar, could you tell?
The root x minus y.
Shamita?
Root x.
Root x, y.
Very
root
good.
Root x, y.
It is square root of x plus y only. Shamita, are you thinking? How is this?
How, sir?
No. I am asking Shamita T. Ekbote. I want your response. No response. Okay, good. I'll tell you why this root x plus y will be the rationalizing factor of this. Okay, this is the given irrational number. Root x plus y. If I multiply this, I should get rational number. This is root x plus 5. Root x plus 5 into root x plus 5. Root x plus 5 whole square. Then square and root get cancelled. X plus y will remain. It is a rational. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Shamita, what are you thinking?
Yes, sir.
Did you understand? Shamita T. Ekpote. Trupti, did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next. Square root of x plus square root of y. Now you tell. Ekta.
Sir,
for this, we have to use conjugate because two terms are there. We can write here root x minus root y.
Minus root y, sir.
Yes. Next one. Sixth one. Square root of 2 minus square root of 3.
Square root of 2 plus square root of 3.
Right. I have written. Square root of 2 plus square root of 3. Number 3 minus root 11. Wait, Sanjana SL, you can conjugate 3 minus root 11. It is 3 plus root 11. I told you, two terms is there, just a sign a chain body. If it is minus, right plus. If it is plus, right minus. That's all. Over.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now we are moving to fourth example. Right. Fourth examples. But nobody has asked me a question that, sir, if three terms are there, what is its rationalizing factor? Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Nobody had gone for thinking. It is work for your mind. You try to collect the information. Already, this is second assignment. One is, why is an irrational number? Nobody has asked me, sir, why it is irrational? But one student, Shamita T. Ekpote, she called and she asked me. Afterwards, nobody. And this is second assignment. How to find out rationalizing factor? Nothing but conjugate of three term irrational number consisting of three terms. Just to think over it. Wait. What is that? What? What examples? Right. First question. Rationalize the denominator of each of the following. Denominator of each of the following. Rationalize the denominator of each of the following. First one, right. It is 1 by 3 into root. Please stop writing and observe. Please stop writing. I've given you sufficient time, no? Observe. Go through the given statement. It is. No. Abhinandan, don't type. Just observe. Go through the statement. Shreya. When the teacher is giving the information, your attention should be here only, not somewhere else. Rationalize the denominator of each of the following. Here, I have given a fraction. We have a term in the denominator also, that is 3 into root 2. So this denominator should be converted into rational. Got it? Okay, rationalize the denominator. Nothing but convert this denominator term into rational number. Please don't write anything. Now, in the denominator, we have 3 into root 2. To convert this into rational, we have to multiply rationalizing factor. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Now, rationalizing factor of denominator, that is 3 into root 2, is, what is its rationalizing factor?
3 into root 2.
Root 2. In the table, there we have written irrational number and another side, rationalizing factor. Rationalizing factor of the denominator is just root 2. Root 2 na idu multiply madidre saaku adu rational agutte. Next, here 1 by 3 into root 2 is there. Now, this denominator should be converted into rational. That is why first I'll write 1 by 3 into root 2 as it is. Okay. You have a habit of writing the information when the teacher explains. First, you should listen to her. Without affecting this, it should be multiplied. That's why, whatever the rationalizing factor we got, it should be multiplied in the numerator as well as the denominator. If I write so, will it affect the given statement?
Yes, no, sir.
No, sir. Hey,
where are you? It will not affect. Is the end effect of the root 2 root 2 must cancel other than the other. Got it? Now, this is equal. Here, 1 multiply numerator term. 1 into root 2. Root 2 only. You know me? 3 into root 2 into root 2. This is 3.
Square.
Now square and root get cancelled.
Cancel.
Now this is equal to root 2
3 into
5. Here 2 is there. 3 2s are
6.
way 6 is rational or irrational?
Rational.
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 The given number in the denominator,
rational
number is there. That is 3 into root 2. It is converted into rational. That is 6. Followed?
Yes, sir.
Once I repeat. Yes, Sanjana, yes, sir, don't try. First observe. Once I tell, denominator. Rationalizing factor of the denominator is root. And this rationalizing factor should be multiplied to the numerator and denominator. Then multiply numerator terms. Multiply denominator terms. Then you will get the denominator term as rational. Please do copy this. Quick as possible.
Sir, if they ask the numerator, we have to write only for numerators.
Yes. Yatin and Yashwant, are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Both of you understood, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mana, sir, have you copied?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Siddesh B.A. Gagandeep, have you copied?
Yes, sir.
Good boy. Shall I move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Wait, sir.
7 by 5 root 3. 7 by 5 into root 3. This time, please go on writing with me. Here. Arushi. What is the first step?
So first step, it is to write the rationalized factor of 5, 3 roots is 3 roots.
Root 3.
Then it will be equal to 7 it by...
Wait. It should be multiplied to the numerator and denominator. Yes, continue. 7 by 5 into root
3. Sir, then it will be... 7 by 5, 3 roots into 3 roots. Then it'll, we have to multiply 7 into 5, 7
wait,
into
wait, root. Wait. It's okay. You just carry on writing.
Sir, I, sir.
Wait. Srinivas, you are right. Correct. Now multiply numerator. 7 into root 3. 7 times root 3. Denominator. 5 into root 3. Into root 3.
Sir, it will be 5 root 3 whole square.
Square and root get cancelled. 7 into root 3 by 5 into 15. Now 15 is rational. Any doubt regarding this?
No, sir.
No. Okay. Now I'll take up another one. Simple one. Third sub question. It is 1 by 2 plus root 3. Sai Gaurav.
Yes, sir.
In the denominator, we have 2 plus root 3. It is binomial irrational number. Sai Gaurav, what is its rationalizing factor? Nothing but conjugate. Sai Gaurav, what is its conjugate?
Sir, can I, sir?
Can I? Hello, sir.
Prajwal SM, you can tell.
Sir, 2 minus root 3.
Very sir. Good, very good. Yes, please write. Solution. Here. Rationalizing factor, nothing but conjugate. Most suitable word is conjugate. Conjugate of 2 plus root 3 is 2 minus root 3. Then, write the given number as it is. That is 1 by 2 plus root 3. Now, this is equal to 1 by 2 plus root 3. Multiply this conjugate to the numerator and denominator. Lavanya, are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Multiply conjugate to the numerator and denominator. It is 2 minus root 3 divided by 2 minus root 3. Numerator, please don't go for disturbing it. Write it as it is. In the numerator, we have 1. If 1 is multiplied to any number, same number only will come. You can write this as it is. 2 minus root 3. Ananya SN. Ananya? Ananya?
Yes, sir.
Ananya SN, are you on the line?
Yes, sir.
Could you tell how can we go for multiplying the denominator terms?
Two squares.
First term same. Second term same. Both the sign is changed. It is plus and this is minus. It is A plus.
Two square minus root three square.
Wait. It is A plus B into A minus B. Can be written as A square minus B square.
A square minus B square.
2 square plus root 3 square.
Now, I'll give you the reason. It is because A plus B into A minus B is equal to A square minus B square. Now, this is equal to numerator as it is, 2 minus root 3. Denominator. Sanvi, what is 2 square?
4.
It is 4. Minus. Root 3 whole square?
9.
Oh, no.
Sir, root? 2 and root will cancel, sir.
So root will get
answer. Sir, 4 minus 3 is equals to 1.
Very good. 4 minus 3, that's equal to 1. Here are line.
Sir, 1 is answer.
This is equal to 2 minus root 3 by denominator. 4 minus 3 is 1. So, where 1 is rational. See, actual denominator is 2 plus 3, root 3. It has been converted into rational. That is 1. I go for giving you the last one, right, quick as possible. Quickly, it is 5 by 4, it is 5 by root 3 minus root 5. Root 3 minus root 5. Please go on writing with me. The denominator is root 3 minus root 5. Write its conjugate. root conjugate of root 3 minus root 5 is root 3 plus root 5. Then write the given number as it is. The given number is 5 by root 3 minus root 5. Multiply this conjugate to the numerator and denominator. Right, that is equal to 5 by root 3 minus root 5 as it is into this conjugate. Root 3 plus root 5 by root 3 plus root 5. This is equal to numerator term, don't discuss, just write them as it is. 5 into root 3 plus root 5. Observe the denominator. It is a minus b and this is a plus b. A minus b into a plus b, again it is a square minus b square.
Root.
Now we can write it is root 3 whole square minus root 5 whole square. You may write the reason that a plus b into a minus b, this is equal to a square minus b square. Next, this is equal to, write numerator as it is 5 into root 3 plus root 5. Denominator, observe. Aditya, Pravin, Anvekar, correct it. Root 3 whole square. Here, square and root get cancelled. Only 3 will remain. Minus square and root get cancelled.
5.
3 will remain. This is equal to 5 into root 3 plus root 5. Denominator. What is 3 minus 5?
Minus two.
Wait. Say yes, hey idiot. Say yes, what are you doing? Huh? Are you playing? Today you should call me by 12:30. Say yes. Rule number 39. Today, without fail, you have to call me by 12:30. I want to talk to you. Yes, others can tell. What is 3 minus 5?
Minus 2.
This can be written as, it is minus 5 by 2 into root 3 plus root 5. Where 2 is in the denominator, which is rational. 2 is rational. Followed?
Yes, sir. So, yes, sir.
Be thinking that, sir, why should we not multiply 5 with these terms?
Sir, then 2 is the answer or minus 2, sir?
Minus 2 is the answer. It has been written as minus 5 by 2 into root 3 plus root 5. Here I have not multiplied 5 with other terms, these two terms. Reason here on the at last there is a chance of cancellation. Hangagi, it should be written as it is. And one more thing, even when you multiply, what did you come to? That is why you should write this as it is. Clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Hema, you okay? Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt, sir.
In today's worksheet also, I'll give you some very important problems related to this. Very important problems related to this. Please work out them without fail. Okay? And please do practice whatever I have taught today also. So, with it is time up. Let's go for conclude the class.
Sir, will you send the video?
Yes, yes.
Sir, will you send a video?
If you need, then you can message me. On requisition only, I can give you. Okay, with this, let us stop the class. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful
day. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.